On October 9th, 2023, at 5:26 a.m. local time, a moderate magnitude 5.0 earthquake struck offshore of a completely uninhabited volcanic pinnacle in Japan's Izu Islands. Despite occurring at a depth of 1,000 meters or 3,281 feet below the top of the seafloor, this quake was not felt by anyone due to its remote location and only modest size. No warnings needed to be issued at first, but then something unexpected occurred. Nearby ocean buoys suddenly detected an irregular wave that lasted for 4 minutes and caused a buoy to rise by a little less than a meter. Suddenly, numerous alerts were sent out warning that a tsunami had been generated to people not only on Japan's Izu and Bonin Islands, but also the east coast of much of Japan and the Ryukyu Islands, with the alert telling people to move to higher ground. As the tsunami raced towards several populated settlements at an average speed of 301 kilometers per hour or 187 miles per hour, the waves slowly decreased in height. Yet, at 6:27 a.m. local time, a 60-centimeter high wave struck the island of Aogoshima, home to a population of 170. It then went on to strike dozens of other cities, reaching numerous coastlines within a 1,000-kilometer or 621-mile radius of the tsunami's origin. Luckily, due to the small maximum run-up height of this tsunami, aka only 23.6 inches, the only reported damage were several small boats that capsized at docks on the islands of Kuzushima and Hachishojima. Yet, here is the problem. Due to this earthquake's only modest magnitude, a tsunami should not have occurred, as it was 125.9 times too small in terms of overall energy to have been expected to generate a tsunami in the traditional sense. Generally speaking, only earthquakes of magnitude 7.1 or larger generate tsunamis, while generally earthquakes with a magnitude of 7.5 or higher have the potential to generate destructive tsunamis. Also, there were several suspicious signs that something unusual occurred. First of all, the region where this earthquake occurred is an area which may have potential undetected active submarine volcanoes. Second, a massive swarm of earthquakes has been occurring in this very region since October 3rd, consisting of 30 magnitude 5 or higher earthquakes, including 3 magnitude 6 range events. If these quakes were to merely represent aftershocks of an earlier larger quake, then the magnitude 6.1 earthquake on October 3rd should have been followed by a maximum aftershock of magnitude 4.9. Yet, 31 earthquakes larger than this occurred over the following 5 days. This earthquake sequence thus had a greater similarity with a volcanic earthquake swarm than a purely tectonic quake sequence. Additionally, a series of earthquakes happened which seemingly occurred at regular intervals of approximately 5 minutes. Such events would make a lot more sense if the tremors were misidentified, instead originating from powerful deep volcanic explosions or caldera subsidence from an undetected submarine eruption like witnessed offshore of Mayotte Island in 2018. But, more importantly, before the earthquake occurred that generated the tsunami, a period of 8 minutes of continuous tremor was detected, which would fit a model of volcanic tremor due to the movement of magma. Also of note is a smaller tsunami which occurred 3 days earlier on October 5th, which resulted from a magnitude 6.1 earthquake. So, did an unknown submarine volcano generate these twin tsunamis? For context, 80% of the ocean floor has never been mapped, and 85% of the world's volcanoes exist in the numerous oceans. Since land volcanoes only encompass 15% of the world's volcanoes, and the ratio of known actively erupting submarine to land volcanoes is 3 to 43, it suggests that we are missing a large number of submarine volcanic eruptions. However, this figure might be misleading, as 75% of the 85% figure represents frequent eruptions at mid-ocean ridges, where tectonic plates spread apart, while only 10% represent actual true submarine volcanoes, like the Aichi Seamount. I looked for evidence of a volcanic eruption via discolored water from satellite and found none, so although we cannot completely rule out a volcanic eruption as a tsunami source, I believe that another explanation is far more likely. As, although a magnitude 7.1 or larger is generally needed to create a tsunami, theoretically speaking, even a magnitude 4.0 earthquake could trigger tsunami if it triggers the voluminous submarine landslide. This is what I think occurred, probably with a deep landslide involving more than 50 million cubic meters of material. The continuous tremor that preceded the main quake was thus probably caused by the massive submarine rock moving at a very slow yet ever-increasing speed before it collapsed in a catastrophic manner. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.